We have learned before that that people who saw the new moon, they had to travel to Yerushalayim in order to offer testimony that they saw the new moon so that the Beit Din could be Mekadesh Lechodesh, to sanctify the new month. In our Mishnah, Rosh Hashanah, Perek Aleph, Mishnah Zayin, we're now going to learn that there was a machloket about the nature of the Edut. What kind of Edut was it? Was it Edut like testimony in court, like every other testimony, or was it not? And that's the subject of an interesting machloket. Says the Mishnah, remember we said that people should travel, and they were even Mechalel Shabbat when they saw the new moon. So what if a father and his son saw the new moon? So normally we say that two people who are related, Abu Bino, a father and a son, they can't testify. God forbid, if a father and a son, they saw a murder or they witnessed a transaction, that Beit Din could not accept both of their testimony. But what about in this case? So if a father and a son say, hey, Dad, look, the new moon. Should they travel? Says the Mishnah, Abu Bino Shiro et HaChodesh, Yelchu, they should go. Why should they go? They can't testify together. Lo Shemi Starfim Zayim Zayim. Let's translate. I'm sorry. It's not that they meet starfim, they can testify. They're combined together. They're not ella, rather. If one of them is pasul, the second one should combine with somebody else. Meaning, let's say a third person saw the moon. Only those two guys and somebody else saw the moon. That third guy is going to show up and say, I saw the moon. So one of them, will testify. Now, what's really interesting, why did it say she'im pasel echad mehem? One of them is pasul. Even if one of them is not pasul, the second one should be mitzdarev. They need a third person to be mitzdarev. Okay, I looked at the Gemara. The Gemara doesn't discuss it. Why does it say she'im pasel? So, well, if you have any thoughts, email me at rspolter@gmail.com. I'd love to hear from you. Rabbi Shimon. So that's the first opinion. So that Av and Beno, they can't testify with each other. Rabbi Shimon Omer. Rabbi Shimon says, Av ubeno v'chol kovim, father, son, all relatives, she'irun le'edut ha'chodesh, they can testify together. How are they to be able to testify together? Let's look at the Gemara. How does he say that? Am Rab Levi, my time with Rabbi Shimon, what's the reason Rabbi Shimon, how could you say, meaning it's a testimony. Dichtiv, as it says, Mayomer Hashem el Moshe ve'el Aaron be'eretz Mitzrayim le'mor, God said to Aaron and Moshe, Moshe and Aaron, in the land of Egypt, ha'chodesh hazeh lachem, that's the pasuk, ha'chodesh hazeh lachem. This month is for you. So the Rabbi Shimon says, what does it mean, Achodesh Hazeh Lachem? Edut zo tehei ksheira bachem. This Edut is ksheira in you. Who is he talking to? Moshe and Aaron. Moshe and Aaron are two brothers. And since Moshe and Aaron are two brothers can testify, that means anybody can testify. The Rabbanan say, no. Edut zo tehei misura lachem. What does it mean, lachem? It's not you. You can't testify. You guys are the guys in charge. You're the chachamim. You are the ones that are supposed to take the testimony. That's what the Chachamim say. If you look at the Bar Tanur, he just quotes this exact Gemara. HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem, Edu Zeh Shachodesh Sheira Bachem. That's what Rabbi Shimon says. V'af Api Shatem Achim. The Rabbanan say, no, HaChodesh Lachem Tu Mesura Lachem. La'gdolim Shebagor Shebotchem. You guys are in charge. You take the testimony. So the Bar Tanur is directly a quote from the Gemara. Amar Rabbi Yossi. Rabbi Yossi says, Ma'aseh B'tuv Yaharofei. There was a story about Tuvia HaRofe, Tuvia, the doctor. What do you got to do to get into the Mishnah? That's world lifetime famousness. Shira'a et HaChodesh B'Yerushalayim. Who saw the new Yerushalayim? Hu ubeno v'avdo mishuchrar. He saw it together with his son and his Eved mishuchrar, his freed slave. And Eved, the slave, would not be kosher for testimony. But since he was freed, he's a Jew for all purposes. He's a Yehudi l'chol davar. So therefore, the three of them saw the new moon. V'kiblu ha-kohanim oto ve'et b'no upaslu et abdo. The Kohanim took him and his son, meaning upaslu et b'no, and they didn't take the Eved. Why? The Eved, Kohanim, they cared about yuchus. What family were you from? What's your status? Kohanim very much cared about that. So they took oto ve'et b'no, him and his son. Ukshiba'u lifnei Beit Din, when they came before Beit Din, kiblu oto ve'et abdo, they took him and his slave, Pasul Epano, they didn't take his son because the father and the son. Because the father and son are Pasul, they pass him like the Rabbanan. Really, really fascinating Mishnah. What is the process? The Kohanim, it seems like there was an intake. The Kohanim interviewed everyone. It's okay, you and the son are okay. Meaning the Kohanim, first of all, they had their own rules, okay? And they pass it like Rabbi Shimon. They wanted to pass on Rabbi Shimon. And then they come before Beit Din, and the Beit Din gives a final psak. So what's going on here? That there's, it's a very interesting dynamic that there's this Kohanim, they have their own rules, but then they you come before Beit Din, the Beit Din sets the final criteria. That's something that's interesting to comment on. I'd love to know your thoughts. Comment, email me, arsmoter@gmail.com. We'll stop and dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Rav Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman.